we're getting a tour of a Pisco winery today.
So we tried the rosé wine, which is for when you have problems. Then we tried the Borgogna, which is the divorce wine. And then we tried this white wine, which apparently is the panty dropper wine. Then we tried the cream wine that has maca in it.
We got some vanilla ice cream with Pisco cream on top. It's really good. So we're now at the Nazca Lines Tower. We're seeing the Nazca Lines at sunset. We got into Nazca after the viewing tower. And there's a bit of a confusion about our hotel picking us up. So we were waiting at this cafe for about 45 minutes. But he eventually showed up, which was great. And now he's essentially taking care of us for the rest of the time we're here, including taking us to the flight tomorrow and back and to the bus pickup to hop back on with Peru Hop. And our room here is super nice for only 55 soles. So yeah, we're now gonna go get dinner down at the main square, which is pretty close. And there's one other guy from Peru Hop with us, so he's gonna come join. And then I think the rest of the night we're gonna just chill out. So we got this purple jelly stuff that's made out of purple corn, and because we've seen a lot of locals walking around with it, so we'll give it a try.
One
it was only one soul,
30,
yeah.
30 cents.
30 cents.
Sachi
papas?
Sachi papas.
Sachi papas. It's essentially hot dogs and french fries. Six souls.
Five souls, actually.
Oh, five. Five souls. It's okay.
So that's Nazca. So we got in just last night. We just did the one day today. Did the Nazca Lines flight. And then like got some random adventure with some other people. Walk down to the plane.
Say hi, everybody.
So we just got here. It was an interesting cab ride. There's five of us piled into this little cab right here. Where is it? It's right there. That little cab right there. And it was 60 souls. Drive us here, wait, and then get us back. But we had to walk around for quite a while. And we had a Spanish speaker with us to wheel and deal. And we're gonna see some mummies or whatever. I don't know, we'll see. Should be good. Oh. Came back from the mummies thing, and we're just one block off Plaza del Armas, just right there, and there's a street, and it's like got like seven souls and like six soul, all like set lunches. So we found one for seven souls that's busy and looks good.
I needed to ask a question,
yeah.
So I asked him, and he went, "Your guide will be here soon."
So right now we're just hanging out at our hostel. We have a bus to Arequipa that leaves at 6:30. Right now it's about 5:30, so we're just hanging out up kind of on the rooftop. Stacey's doing some video work. there. That's the magic happening right there. I didn't have super high expectations for Nazca, and I think maybe that's why I enjoyed it so much. I thought we would just sit around and get some editing done and just kind of like hang out, relax, do some laundry or whatever. But it ended up being a really good city. It wasn't super touristy. Nobody was like constantly bugging us, trying to get us to buy things or whatever. We just like walked around the square with the locals, got the local deals. It was really good. I really enjoyed Nazca, and Stacy and I both sort of weren't expecting to enjoy Nazca like this. So yeah, definitely come spend more time here. If you don't like sort of the tourist bustle of like Huacachina or Paracas or whatever,